rafters. I was an angel living in the garden of evil, screwed up, scared, doing anything that I needed.
Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So basically I just wanted to film this video for you guys. So I dedicated this video for all the pale people out there, pale girls or guys. I am pale, let me just tell you. Like, I am pale. And I wanted to make a complimentary makeup look for all the pale people out there, because if I was pale skin, they have a hard time looking for the perfect bronzer, or the perfect blush, or the perfect lip color. Because when you're pale, you don't want to pick too dark of a lip color, and you don't want to pick too dark of a bronzer. But I picked all the colors in this YouTube tutorial was very neutral and very complimentary. And also, you can see if you have really, really dark skin or really, really pale skin. So I wanted to film this video, and the last few videos I simply guys that I wanted to master the video. And yeah, I had a lot of fun filming this look. Everything that I used in this makeup look, I love. Everything turned out great. Even the highlight I love. I love feeling as fuck. And yeah, like I love this look color. It's very like pinky nude. It's like not too dark. It's like the perfect nude for pale skin. I find a lot of people have a hard time using pale makeup. And I find like a lot of lines, they don't have a diversity of colors. Like your pale tones are really dark tones. And you know, Kat Von D, her blocking foundation is a really good example. Like, they have a color in there that's like white. I have a few friends that are even more pale than me. Like, they're white. Like, I'm pretty, like, I would say I'm pale, but a lot of people don't think of me as that pale. But some of my friends are even whiter. Like, they are Caucasian, but they love the Kat Von D line because they have a more pale shade. And like, I think it's really hard when you're really dark and you're really pale. It's hard to find a certain foundation. My shade is just light with a little bit of a cool rose tone. And how you can tell how pale you are is like the veins. So, like, if you have more of a cool tone like myself, I have blue veins. If you're more like an olive tone like my mom, she has a hint of yellow, but she's got more like green veins. That's why she has like a more olive undertone. So, you can always tell that. Or even Google it, like, it tells you everything. Or you can go to Sephora, like, when they are open after this pandemic, they have a little IQ machine and they test your back. So much fun filming it for you. I had a lot of fun. I did a really soft brown smoky eye, just because when you're pale, you don't want a harsh black smoky eye, which I've done before, but for this type of paleness look, I wanted to do a really soft brown, because I find if you guys are pale and you find like dark smoky eyes, it's a little too harsh and it doesn't complement your skin tone because you're pale, use a brown, especially a brown like liner, which is what I use. It's not too dark. I find when I do this look, everybody loves how I do my makeup, because it's just like effortless and soft and natural and people love it. But when I do like a crazy look, they don't really like it. But I think because it like it shows my like pretty natural features, like it's not too crazy. This would be really fun for like a glam look, I think, because I curl my hair, I have these pretty earrings. Yeah. Anyways, you guys, I really hope you guys enjoy this video. I didn't talk too much during the video just because I feel like a little dehydrated. Like, I kept talking and drinking coffee in between. I might cut that part out, but some of the stuff I couldn't cut out because it was, like, hard because I kept drinking. But I've been staying inside, so I haven't gone anywhere, like, because I don't want to get sick. Yeah, so I just been chilling at home, eating, cooking, not drinking because I don't really drink, but just chilling at home. But I'm going to edit this video as soon as I can so you guys can see this video for yourselves and try this look at home. It was really, really easy and simple, and I had a lot of fun doing it. Anyways, you guys, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel so you guys can be updated for all different types of looks. I loved it so much. Thank you. I love you as always. Thanks for watching. Bye. Hey, you guys. So I just thought I would do, obviously, my foundation, concealer, powder, and eyebrows. I look very pale, so I think this video is going to be pretty in-depth how to have the most complimentary makeup on pale skin, which I wanted to do. I'm quite pale, as you can tell on my face. So we're gonna get started. So I just thought I would like contour, bronze, and bake on camera. So basically, we're gonna contour using the shading powder, I think what it's called, in the contour powder, and called Shadester. So I'm gonna use, I'm just gonna use this brush. This is the Morphe R10. We're just gonna dip in there really lightly because this powder is very pigmented, as you guys know. It's more like not really like a contour powder. It's kind of contour and a bronzy, but I want that bronzy glow because we don't want to be pale. We want to warm up the face like this. It's gonna be really pretty and nice. And we don't want too much powder on the forehead. Just because I find it's funny when like women put bronzer powder here and then you just have this, it looks funny. You wanna like frame the face, but you don't wanna do too much. You don't wanna go overboard. Okay, now for bronzer, I want to use a really neutral kind of bronzer with a neutral undertone. So I love using the Too Faced Chocolate Soleil bronzer. They actually just changed the packaging on everything. I dropped it, so a little piece came out, but I'm lucky it didn't completely break. And this smells like chocolate. Oh, it smells so good. I wish you guys could smell it, but I love this bronzer. It's not too dark. It's not too, like, orangey. I find the Hoola is really good when I'm a little more tan, but this is perfect because there's no, like, real orangey kind of reddish undertone. It's just a really neutral bronzer, and it's going to be really complimentary with a lot of pale skin tones. Like if you're really, really pale, this is a really good bronzer that you guys should invest in. I'm just going to use the Morphe R2 brush. I love this brush. You guys know I'm just going to dip in there and bronze away. Enough of Chatty Cathy from Angelique. We're just gonna use the Laura Mercier translucent setting powder. We're just gonna bake the bottom half of the face. You guys know I love this powder for baking the bottom half of the face. Just because I ate some food earlier. Okay, now we're going to use the Jaclyn Hill palette. You guys know I love this palette. We're just going to go in with Silk Cream. We're going to use this shade. Very loved, by the way. I'm just going to use this R37 brush. Just dip in there. Just dip, dip, dip. Because I don't have much left. I'm just going to apply that all over the lid. We're kind of going to do like a brown smoky eye. I find when you're really, really pale, kind of like black smoky eye, like the one I did a few months ago. It's called My Sexy Date Night Smoky Eye Ombre. I did a really dark smoky eye with some black colors. That look is really complimentary if you're tanned, but this is the smoky eye I always go to when I feel like I'm super, super pale, like I am right now. Yeah, I'm just going to place that color all over the lid. which NW means like the cooler shade, and NC is more of the warmer shade. That's how their coating does. Yeah, I was. People said I look Filipino, which I'm not. Okay, now I'm just going to bake under the eye. I'm just going to use the Fenty Beauty Instant Retouch Setting Powder Pro Filter in the shade Lavender. I love this, especially when I'm pale. This is the perfect powder. So it's perfect that I have this still. And I only bought this once, and it's lasted me so long, you guys. Okay, we're just going to... I don't know why, but as long as you have powder under there, you won't get fallout. I don't know why I'm so thirsty. Okay, we're just gonna continue with that Silk Cream color, just because you just want like a light wash of color, because we're gonna use some darker browns and it's gonna fade really nicely when we apply those darker browns. We're gonna use this one. This is the Jaclyn Hill Armed and Gorgeous palette. This is one of my favorite palettes. Ooh, and we're just gonna use this kind of but it's like a neutral kind of brown, medium brown. It's called Prowl. It's really pretty. And it's going to look perfect with this eye look, because we want something neutral. When you're pale, it just complements really well. If you're like, if you're doing too much of an orange kind of smoky eye, it's not going to be very flattering. It's usually like more flattering if you're more tanned. So I'm just going to dip into that shade, that flat definer brush, and we're just going to line the lash line. I love using this brush for this method because it just applies really easily. I used to always like do this with this. This is for like your lower lash line, not for the lash line on top. I just find this is way easier because it's like long and it has like a perfect edge at the end. Line it, and then we're just going to take more of that color, that Prowl, and just flick it out. Just flick it out. I know it looks funny, but trust me, we're gonna blend it out later, and it's gonna look fire. Just like my eyes look smaller, and also wearing like white eyeliner, not black per se, opens up your eyes way more. Okay, now we finish lining the eyes. I look a little crazy. That's okay. We're just going to use this blending brush. This is the JH33, but this is also equivalent to the Morphe M433, I believe. And then we're just going to take that Prowl shade again, but we're going to use a fluffy brush and just pat that into the product. Not too much, but just enough. And then just take that into the crease and like really buff it out. It's going to give you like that effortless kind of brown smoky eye, what we're looking for, especially when you're pale. Like this color is so complimentary. I love it. I love like it's not too dark, but it's dark enough. And it has such a beautiful neutral undertone. I'm going to use a different brush now. I'm just going to use this brush. This is like a shorter, more dense brush, which is perfect for blending any harsh lines. This is the JH35. I'm going to look at a brush it's similar to. Yeah, it's similar to this one. This one's a little longer, but this is the Morphe 510, but I'm just going to use this one because I want to. And then we're just going to blend it with another shadow. It's a little bit darker than Silk Cream, but not as dark as Pukey. So we're going to go in with the Pooter shade, and this is always the perfect color I use to blend any dark shadows because it's like that little perfect middle shade, middleman, that you can take to blend any harsh lines. Okay, So we're just gonna take that and softly blend that out. And just like tap really lightly because these shadows are very pigmented. Just like that. Perfect. The finer brush. And I'm just gonna go back. I'm gonna use the shade Central Park just to deepen that lash line because we don't want that to be completely removed. We just wanna add some more depth. And just tap the excess off and just like stamp where you see that line we used before. You kinda can see it. So it's pretty easy to trace it again. So this is just going to deepen it. When we apply the lashes, it's just going to elongate those lashes. It's going to look really easy. And if you guys struggle with lashes, this lash line right here, when we put the shadow on, is going to be really easy just to apply the lashes. So if you guys think like you can't apply lashes and it's hard for you to see to apply the lashes, I always put like a liner and you just pop them on and it basically like has a straight line, so it's easy for you guys to apply the lashes. Like I used to do that trick when I was younger and it works every time. Here we go, that's better. Okay, we're just gonna use this pouder shade for the lower lash line. And we're just gonna use this buffer brush. This is the JH37. This is always the brush I use. And we're just gonna apply on the lower lash line. Perfect. Okay, now we're gonna do eyeliner. I think I'm gonna use, I'm gonna use this one. This is the MAC Eye Cool, but in the shade Teddy. I always use the white one, which is fascinating, but this is Teddy. Yeah, this one has a really pretty sparkle in it. And whenever I do like eyeliner and I don't want to be too intense, I always use like a brown shade or a shimmery shade. It complements really well. So if you guys don't want your eyes to look too harsh, always use a brown, not black. I don't know why it's not working, but who cares? There we go. I think this eye's a little bit watery, so. There we go. That's good enough. Okay, now we're gonna go in with the darker shade. I'm just going to use the same brush because I don't have the need to use a different brush. I'm just going to use the M432. And then we're just going to use that Central Park shade, that dark espresso color. And just tap the excess off and just go underneath the lash. But don't worry, we're going to blend it out. Perfect. And we're just going to use this pencil brush. This is the JH38. I'm just going to use that silk cream color. We're just going to use the same color as what we did with the top lid. So we want it to be really cohesive and complement each other like that. It's a really pretty, like, neutral brown. Eye a little bit smokier and blown out. I'm just going to use this Kylie brush and just dip into that silk cream color. Just like that. There we go. It's looking real cute. Okay. I'm just going to put some more baking because I just want to perfect that lower lash line even more. I'm just going to carve out my eyebrows real quick. Just because. I'm telling you, I love this brush, you guys. It's like so versatile. And I love using my concealer with it. Okay. Now to set that concealer, because I'm pale, I'm just going to use this in light shade because it's a really pale highlight. But when I'm tan, I usually use Beam and in light. Where's my brush? I'm just going to use a smudger guy. This is the JH42. Oops. We're just going to use a little bit at a time. Because this is a very pigmented highlight. Yeah, that's intense. Like that. Ooh, yeah. Okay, now we're going to do something different. I'm just going to use this Arm and Gorgeous palette from Jaclyn Hill. I'm just going to use this VIP shade. It's more like a white, and I think it's going to really pop in the inner corner. That's just something different, you know? Yeah, like it just hits the light, you know? Love this VIP shade. Okay. And then we're just gonna contour with that Chocolate Soleil bronzer. I'm just using this slanted goat hair Kylie brush. And we're just gonna softly contour the nose. Because you're so pale, you don't want to like rough, like go in too darkly with your nose contour because it'll look really, really funny. Like, yeah, it would just look funny. Which I'm always careful because I don't like myself to have a really like prominent nose contour just because like I have a high bridge and I don't want to emphasize that. Okay. Now we're just going to take that baked off a little bit. There we go. I'm looking real cute. Okay, now because I'm so pale, I'm going to use the MAC Pro Shaping Powder in the shade Emphasis. This is a beautiful powder if you're really, really pale. It's more like a satin powder. It's not matte. It's not shimmery. It's like more of a satin. And this is one of their top sellers. I know it's really itchy. Okay, and we're just going to use the sponge again. You know I hit pan, so I got to dip in there. And we're just going to pat really lightly under the eye. And this is just gonna like give your under eye life. And it's gonna give you a really nice, angelic, kind of ethereal, like soft look. It's gonna like just make your eyes, your under eyes pop a little bit.
and just like.
Right. Now we're gonna move on to mascara. I'm just gonna use the L'Oreal Luminous Lash Paradise. This is my favorite mascara of all time.
My nose.
It's really itchy. Oh! Cover it up when we apply lashes. I'm such a clutch sometimes. And then I'm just going to go in with the Flutter Intoxicating Double Lift Lashes. You guys know this is my favorite lashes. But I'm going to do it off camera just because it's going to save time for the video. And I get really ugly when I put lashes on. I'll be right back.
So I applied lashes. I'm loving the eye look.
I'm loving this look, but I look a little dead because we're going to bronze and fix the face and give the face some warmth. We're just going to take that bandage off first. And we're just going to use some of that setting spray and that sponge. Just tap in the skin really lightly. Okay, and then we're just going to use that shaping powder from MAC in Emphasis. And we're just going to dip in there. And pat that below the face. And this is just gonna pull the face together. I know it looks super pale, but it's gonna come together and it oxifies. Yeah, later when we put the settings right now, it's just gonna like glow. Yeah, like don't worry. It's gonna settle, don't worry. Okay, now we're just going to go back in with that bronzer from Too Faced, the Chocolate Soleil bronzer. Oh, it smells so good. You guys gotta smell it. And I love the new packaging they have. It's super, super cute. I'm just making sure my eyelashes are on. I love this bronzer. It looks so good on pale skin. Done. I'm gonna go in with a blush now. I'm just gonna use this Morphe blush palette. I've used this before on camera. This is the blush palette from Morphe. It's called the Warm Master 8W because there's 8 shades. And I think I'm gonna go in with this really pink one and Unapologetic. Ooh! Oh my God. This is not my setting spray over. I'm just gonna use a blush brush that I wanna use. I'm just gonna use this from the Gold Collection. This is the Y4. I love this Morphe blushes. They're really like pigmented and soft. Yeah, that's really pretty. I want a really warm cheek just because we're so pale. We just want to warm up the cheeks. So when you are super pale, you don't want a smoky eye. You don't want to look dead. And I always use like really corally kind of blushes, which I find it complements any eye look just because it warms up the face. But we're gonna diffuse it soon. Just bear with me. I do love blush though. And also blush fades really quickly on me, so that's why. Okay, and then we're gonna go in with the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder. This is in the shade Luminous Light. I always use this. I'm just gonna use this M500 brush. And this is just gonna diffuse the blush and give you a really nice soft glow. and I always use this product, like, for brides. It's really beautiful because it gives you that ethereal kind of soft, glowy skin. And if you guys don't want a beaming highlight, you could just use this. This would be so beautiful on its own. But I'm secretly a drag queen inside and got a glow AF, so I'm not going to just use this. And I like it. It just gives you a really nice skin glow. See, just gives you a really nice soft glow. Okay. Now we're just gonna set the face before we go on go in with our actual highlights. So this is the Morphe Continuous Setting Spray. And then we're just gonna use my Amazon fan just to cool that setting spray before we go in with actual highlight, because you don't want your cheeks to be wet when you apply the highlight or it won't blend. It'll be really choppy, which we don't want, and will ruin our makeup, which we don't want. And just careful when you do any matte eye, like, don't spray any setting spray and then open it. You're gonna crease your eyeshadow. These are little steps I've learned over the years. Okay, so for actual highlight, I'm going to use, this is from Benefit Cosmetics. This is the Cheek Leader Bronze Squad. And we're going to use the highlight called, Cookie. I love this highlight. It has, like, more of a, what do you call it? I'll swatch it for you. Like, it has a really creamy, like, highlight. Like, it goes on the skin more like a gel. It's really pretty. Yeah, it's hard to explain. It's not a powder, but it's like, it goes on really smoothly. I'll show you. I don't know if I used this before. I think I have, but, well, I'm just going to apply really softly onto the cheeks. Yeah, it just gives you a really nice kind of skin-like highlight. They have, I should actually use it more on camera, but, well, okay, now, let me just read, yeah, so it's a super silky powder, good to know, good to know, and that's a really nice highlight if you're pale or you're tanned. I find when it really complements when I'm tan because it kind of has a hint of gold. But when I'm pale, it just gives you that white kind of glow. Okay, now we're going to go in with the powder highlights. And I'm going to use the color. This is from Kylie Cosmetics. This is her loose highlighter in Santorini. She has another one that I love. And I love pairing it with that cookie highlighter. It's called Fiji. But this is the lighter one. This is the more white one. And because we're pale, we want to complement that paleness. And it's just going to make you glow. Okay. I'm just going to tap a little bit on the brush. I don't want too much. And just kind of like buff that all over the cheek. Oh gosh. That's so pretty. Oh yeah. That's hydrated the lips really quickly. Yeah, look at that highlight. Like, I could stop traffic with that. Okay, I'm just gonna rub it into the skin and then just use the sponge to pat that out. Okay, I think because I'm pale, I want something to complement the paleness, so I don't want a really, really dark lip. So I'm gonna go in with Kylie Cosmetics. What's new? And I love, her liquid lip. I love her lip glosses. She has a lip liner I want to use. Okay, I'm going to go in with her Kylie Cosmetics lip liner called Bare. This is one of my favorites. It's a really, I'll swatch it for you guys. It's a really like pretty pink and it's not too dark. It's going to complement this lip color. I mean, this eye look, not lip color. And I love her lip liners. They're so, so, so creamy. To compare, I would say it's way creamier than the Charlotte Tilbury, if you guys like creamy lip liner. I know people don't like creamy lip liners. If you don't, just stick with the MAC Cosmetics. Those aren't as creamy, but they're still workable. But if you don't like too creamy, I definitely suggest using the Charlotte Tilbury. They're a little bit more expensive, but they last you a really long time. Pigmented, I love it. I am running low on this lip liner, so. Okay. And then for liquid lips, I'm going to use the Kylie Cosmetics Velvet Liquid Lipstick. So this isn't her matte, because I find her matte is a little too matte, but this one is a little more hydrating because it's a velvet. It's kind of like more of a satin lip, but it's called Velvet. Like, I'll swatch it for you guys. It's really pretty. It's a really pretty nude. It's like a pinky nude. That's such a pretty color, you guys. Really pretty. I love it. And she also has that color in the matte collection if you want more of the matte, because I know a lot of girls and guys really love matte liquid lipsticks. Okay, just because my lips are super dry and I love lip gloss, I love how your look looks with lip gloss on. I'm a gloss girl. That's how I always been. I just find like it makes the look really complete, and I'm into that. If you're not, just skip this step, but I'm gonna use the Kylie Cosmetics lip gloss in So Cute. This is my favorite lip gloss from her. I use this in almost every video. It's her palest nude, and it's a really good formula. I'll just show you the color on the back of my hand, and it's gonna complement this look. It's so pretty. I love the applicator. Okay, we're just gonna quickly paint this on. Now, we're just gonna spray with the Morphe Continuous Setting Mist just to seal the deal, okay? Yes, bitch. Okay, now we're just gonna set the eyebrows really quickly. We're gonna use the Anastasia Clear Eyebrow Gel. This is my favorite brow gel. Not really into colored brow gels because, I don't know, I think my eyebrows are dark enough and I tint my eyebrows. If you guys like that type of video, I could show you how I tint mine. I have my makeup artistry diploma. So I go to the beauty supply store to get the tint. We're just gonna apply some lower lash mascara. I'm just gonna go in with the MAC Extended Play Giga Black Lash. My God, I memorized the name, even though it's so, so long of a name. Oh, I just poked myself in the eye. Guys, that is it for this video. I'm gonna call this video complimentary makeup for pale skin for girls and boys. I think I'm gonna call that. I don't know. I think I might call it complimentary makeup for pale skin tones. I am pale since I don't tan anymore, especially now. Oh my God, my hair is so greasy.
This is the third day. I usually wash my hair every second day, but this is the third day. I look like a grease ball, but I just thought I would style my hair really quickly before I have a shower, because my man's supposed to come over today, but he said he might not because he's still working at home. But I told him I'm just at home filming a video and cleaning all day. Anyways, you guys, I really loved this video, how it turned out. Whenever I'm like in a rush, or I'm obviously really, really pale, this is the makeup I always go to. It was really, really easy and simple, and I loved it. Yeah, I just love like how like subtle, but yet smokiness this is. And when I do this look, a lot of women and guys always compliment this makeup, because it's like sexy, but it's like natural at the same time. And like the highlights really glowy, like they love it. And you know what I find? When I have the most bang smoky eye, like I spent like over an hour doing it, no one says anything. But when I do something really subtle like this, or quick and easy, that's when people compliment me. It's so weird. I think because it's like looks effortless, and it's just like so sexy and subtle. But you can wear this without lashes, but I always wear lashes because I'm so used to them. And I find when you apply lashes to like a really natural eye, like you use one or two transition shades and you add lashes, it just makes such a difference, especially these lashes, because they're so sexy and pretty, and they just like, you know, complete the look overall. And I love the highlight, the lip color, everything about this look. And it just brings my features together. I find when I don't apply a lot of makeup, and it just like brings out those subtle pretty features of your face really nicely. And I think that's why people like when I apply this look. But oh, my hair is so greasy, I gotta wash it. But yeah, I had a lot of fun filming, you guys. I don't know what kind of video I should film next. I have no idea, to be honest. I was thinking filming a dark smoky eye, like a date night smoky eye, but with like a really pretty green color. I was thinking, since I did the Bling Boss palette, I want to do like a dark smoky eye playing with the Dark Magic palette. That'll be really sexy. I want to use this trickery color. I might do that tomorrow. Or I was thinking doing like maybe play with some yellows, like that'll be really fun. Or I might do that for my birthday. I'm not really sure what kind of other look. And also in my last video, the purple smoky eye I did, the Bling Boss purple smoky eye, people loved that look on me. So a lot of people wanted me to do, so I mentioned in my last video that I wanted to do like a rose gold smoky eye. I might do that for my next video. Who knows? We'll see how I'm feeling. I might even do like a natural glitter smoky eye. That'll be fun. I have lots of ideas to film for you guys since I have all the time in the world right now. So, you know, I have lots of free time, which is why I've been filming a video almost every single day. And I've been having so much fun filming. Like, I actually look forward to filming every day. I used to be really shy when I first started my YouTube channel. The first video, I was so nervous. And I remember my mom kept saying, like, I clapped during the video. I was like, I don't even realize I do that. And she's like, it's because you're nervous. I was like, so what if I'm nervous? You try to have a YouTube channel and not be nervous. But now I'm so comfortable talking into the camera for you guys. I have a lot of fun filming, and I love doing different types of videos. My favorite about filming, like, I love putting all the products I put down in the description box when I'm uploading my video. I have a lot of fun editing it as well. So bomb ass. Also, a lot of you guys been asking, since it's April and last month I did my favorites, my current favorite beauty routine, I thought maybe I could do one for April. And I was thinking of doing a pink eye look, like a really pretty pink eye look. I might do that for my next video. Oh, we'll see what I decide. So far I might do that dark green one tomorrow, maybe do the current favorites, beauty favorites, and then I also have a couple ideas for my birthday. So I want to film a really fun video on my birthday, because why not? It's my fucking birthday and I want to take pictures. That's how it is. Anyways, you guys, I hope you guys enjoy this video. If any other looks you guys want me to do, I would of course love to film for you. Like anything you guys want, just let me know. I'll do it. I'm here for you guys. I'm here to film since I got all the time in the world. I actually cleaned my whole house today and I filmed. It's been a very productive day. Anyways, you guys, I gotta go. Love you so much and thanks for watching. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Bye.
I'm scared when anything that I needed. Shining like a fiery beacon, you got that medicine I need. Tame the good love, give it to me slowly. Put your hands on my waist, do it softly. Me and God, we don't get along, so now I see. No one's gonna take my soul away. Living like Jim Morrison, headed towards a fucked up holiday. Monsters, please, please, and I'm singing. Fuck yeah, give it to me. This is heaven, what I truly want. This innocence is lost. In the land of gods and monsters, I was an angel. Looking to get fucked hard, like a goopy incognito posing as a real singer. Life imitates art, you got that medicine I need. Don't shoot it up straight to the heart, please. I don't really wanna know what's good for me. God's dead, I said, baby, that's alright with me. No one's gonna take my soul away. Living like Jim Morrison, headed towards a fucked up holiday. Monsters, please, please, and I'm singing. Fuck yeah, give it to me. This is heaven, what I truly want. It's innocence lost. Innocence lost. Talk, it's like a movie and you're making me crazy. Cause life imitates art. If I get a little prettier, can I be your baby? You tell me life isn't that hard. No one's gonna take my soul away. I'm living like Jim Morrison, headed towards a fucked up holiday. Monsters, please, please, and I'm singing. Fuck yeah, give it to me. This is heaven, what I truly want. It's innocence lost. Innocence lost.